Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. This is a pathology video on respiratory pathology. The topic is bronchial asthma, the mediators and morphology of bronchial asthma. This is by Dr. CSBR Prasad, Professor of Pathology, Sri Devrajaras Medical College.
Why skin pricks? And there are two types of reactions that can be appreciated in asthma, that is acute immediate response and late phase reactions. So in acute so primary mediators are I told you already, Th2 differentiation is associated with the stimulation of this B cells to produce IgE, and in addition to that there will be recruitment of eosinophils because of interleukin 5 is produced by the Th2 cells, and mast cell recruitment. And this recruitment is associated with histamine release, which is a bronchoconstrictor, and also there are some cholinergic reactions that can occur, which are associated with stimulation of the smooth muscle to facilitate further the bronchoconstriction. Eosinophilic chemotactic factor and neutrophilic chemotactic factors also released in these reactions, and because of this there will be increased entry of eosinophils and neutrophils to the site of reaction, especially this tracheobronchial tree. And secondary mediators, leukotrienes C4, D4 and E4, they are responsible for bronchospasm and increased vascular permeability, and they stimulate the mucus glands to produce lots of mucin. So there will be bronchospasm, increased vascular permeability resulting in edema, and increased mucus production. All will cause what is known as increased thickness, narrowing of the lumen of the bronchial tree, and probably sometimes this thick mucus can cause obstruction, complete obstruction of the tracheobronchial passages. And prostaglandins again may play a role in the form of bronchospasm, vasodilation, bringing about the same changes, almost say similar to leukotrienes. And platelet activating factors, again the granules of secretion which are associated with probably stimulate, facilitate this process of bronchoconstriction and increase vascular permeability. Coming to late phase reactions, are brought about by recruitment of more and more inflammatory cells, which starts around 4 to 8 hours later and persists for a prolonged period of 12 to 24 hours. So this is mediated by release of histamine releasing factor and major basic protein from the eosinophils, and which are directly damaging to the epithelial cells and neutrophils, and they cause inflammatory reaction because of they possess lots of enzymes. Coming to the second category of asthma, that is non-atopic, these patients will not have any history of family history of asthma or allergies, and their serum IgE levels will be normal, and they are not associated with any allergic manifestations, and usually skin test will be negative, and it is due to hyper irritability of the bronchial passages towards some agent. And one should not forget drug induced asthma. Sometimes drugs can induce asthma. Of notable examples is aspirin. So some are very sensitive to aspirin, and they can land in asthmatic attacks whenever they consume aspirin. It is due to preferential inhibition of COX pathway without affecting lipoxygenase pathway. So because of this, there is lots of leukotrien production, and this leukotriene C4, D4, E4, as we have seen earlier, they cause bronchoconstriction, increased vascular permeability, and also increased synthesis of mucin. And one more category is bronchopulmonary aspergillosis, which may be associated with allergies in the upper in the respiratory passages. And this is usually an example for type 1 IgE induced reaction, and in the initial stages, but later it may be converted into type 3 variety of reaction. That is, type 3 is antigen antibody mediated complex reaction. Okay. and sometimes occupational asthma. So whenever the occupation only dictates asthma, so when these patients are taken away from their job and or located into some other jobs, probably they are completely relieved of this asthma. This may be due to fumes from the epoxy resins and plastic industries, and it may be due to organic chemicals, organic substances or chemicals like dust, wood and cotton when they are working with that. And gases may be chemicals like toluene gases or xylene, and other chemicals like formaldehyde, penicillin, they precipitate asthmatic attacks. Otherwise they don't suffer from asthma when they are not exposed to these type of chemicals. So usually again it is a type 1 IgE, type 1 IgG, IgE mediated, sorry, this must be IgE mediated, and liberation of bronchoconstrictor directly. They may stimulate the system to produce bronchoconstrictors, and there may be some unknown varieties of hypersensitivity in these individuals. Morphology, grossly, the lungs involved in this bronchial asthma are overinflated, and there may be small areas of atelectasis. And occlusion of bronchial and bronchioles, bronchi and bronchioles, with thick tenacious mucus, and they plug the air passages, resulting in probably absorption variety of collapse, that is called as atelectasis. Patchy atelectasis is another feature of lung involved in this bronchial asthma. You can see that opened up chest of a patient who died of status asthmaticus, even though lungs appear normal, they are over inflated and almost covering the anterior portions of the heart. And these asthmatic patients sometimes can bring about the tenacious sputum, which forms the cast of this tracheobronchial tree. You can see that branching tenacious sputum. So if you look at the microscopy of the lung involved in this process of bronchial asthma, if you examine the sputum, this sputum will have what is known as Cushman spirals. It is nothing but thick tenacious mucus in the form of spirals with adherent epithelial cells, and sputum will have lots of eosinophils, and the eosinophilic major basic protein derived from the eosinophils are responsible for crystallization, which can be appreciated as charcot-laden crystals. And if you look at the microscopy of the bronchial tree, you will see thickening of basement membrane. I have shown you in the earlier slide, thickening of the basement membrane. Then you will see inflammatory infiltration, and there will be increased number of submucosal glands, mucus producing submucosal glands, and hypertrophy of the smooth muscle. So smooth muscle hypertrophy, increased number of submucosal glands, and lots of inflammatory cells, and thick basement membrane. So these are the changes. And finally, to close, the two terms you should know. So walk-through wheeze and walk-through angina. Sometimes the patient who lands in asthmatic attacks, if he continues to walk, probably he gets relieved. So why this relief from bronchoconstriction? Because of this apprehension and tension, and the exercise is associated with the release of adrenaline, and which is a smooth muscle relaxant with respect to the bronchial passages, and the patient gets relieved. And similarly, there is one more term, walk-through angina. So if you look at the ischemic heart disease, sometimes this ischemic heart disease associated with anoxia or hypoxia. So the cellular metabolism is towards anaerobic metabolism. The end product of anaerobic metabolism is lactosidosis, lactic acid, and this lactic acid is a vasodilator. So the person, to start with, when he is walking or doing some exercise, he lands in ischemic heart disease, develops chest pain, but because of non-help, if he continues to walk sometimes, he gets relief. It is due to what is known as the production, anaerobic metabolism, production of lactic acid, which is a vasodilator, coronary vasodilator, and it is a locally acting mechanism which may sometimes relieve angina attack. So thank you.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe by clicking the button subscribe.